Hi guys, so Devon here, and this video that we'll be doing today is a follow-up to the video that we did on the market depth level 2, right? So the video that we'll be doing today is time and sales, and we'll be going over how you can customize the time on sales to set it up to the color that you would like to represent the various prices that the bid and the ask is hitting, right? I think this is a very important video because one, a lot of traders who are scalpers, or you know, you have a shorter time frame that you're trading and you're using the market depth, would want to get a better understanding of how to set the time in sales, the color that you'd want, and how to use the time in sales. And if you're using the time in sales, it's a high possibility that you already know how to use the time in sales. Now, to get to the time in sales, I already have it up here, but to get to the time in sales, you would go to the option at the top left here that says terminal, scroll down to where it says time in sales, which is here. And you just select it and it would open up the time in sales, right? The time in sales is usually opened right beside the market depth, and you could just have it attached to the workspace, or you could have it detached. For now, we're going to have it attached because we get to see more depth. Right? We get to see prices that are filling in more depth. Now we'll be going over the time in sales and how to configure it. Now, one important feature here to understand with the software, I would have pointed this out in other videos, previous videos, is how to link each panel to other panels. And you do that by selecting on the link here. When it's not already linked, you would get a link icon. You would just select it and match it to a color. Now, the color, the panel that it's linked to, it's linked to the charts, and it's also linked to the market depths, right? So here we'll go ahead and we're looking at REN. REN is currently up 255% for the day. Here we can see it on the market depth, and we're gonna look at that on the time in sales. Now, the prices that you're seeing in red are the prices that are being filled on the bid, right? They're hitting the bid. And the prices that are being filled on blue are the prices that are being hit on the ask. The ones that are white are the ones that are being filled between the bid and the ask, right? So say, for example, a lot of traders, they're used to the price that are hitting the ask to be filled in green, to be filtered out in green. Now, in order to change the color, what we'll do, we'll right-click and we'll go to settings, always settings. And then here we have the option. We see a view. Now, it shows some options here, but this is not what we're looking at. We're looking at the colors because we're looking to set it up. However, if you want to change the font, the grid, to add a grid or not, or to change the rows limit, or the time format, anything, show size in general, default lots, of course, we would change it here. Now, also, we can select these options to round position, show quotes, as well as aggregation. However, we'll be going to changing the color. So here we have the prints. And this is the most important thing, because the prints is showing the color that the prices are being filled at, right? Now, above ask, we would put a lighter shade of green. Let's use this. And at ask, we will use darker shade of green. We're gonna just keep the bid and the bid at the bid and below the bid at this color here, and the at bid at a darker shade of red, right? Because this is not red. Right. And as I mentioned, between the spread, which is prices that are between the bid and the ask, which is between the spread, is gray. Right. And then we have the quotes, which is also gray. And then we just select apply. And you notice right as I select apply, it changes. Now, the prices that are being filled on the ask are being filled at green. And we could change out the columns as well. So here we have symbol at the front and as the first column, and then we have time as the second column, So we could set it up to configure it to what we want. So if we move price over here, we would see price would be the second column. And we have size as well as source. So we can change these out and move them over in order to adjust them, to adjust the column to what we would like, right? And that is basically how you do it. And when we have three options at the top here, so we have the columns. And if we select columns here, we're seeing the options here, right? Where we see symbol, time, price, size, source, and side. So this is showing side. If we select that, when we press apply, it's going to show us, well, as I explained earlier, the red is on the sell side and the green is on the buy side and is showing none because it's being filled between the bid and the ask, right? If we uncheck that, but it says check that and select apply and it applies it. Now for more action, we can set as default, resell, reset to default, or reset to factory, right? And those are all the column options that we have, right? And for the coloring rows, that's not very important because unless you want to take it to that step, but the most important thing is to change out the colors to set it to something that you would like to better suit you on which price we'd be filling on the bid, ask, and between the spread, right? And I hope this video gives you a brief understanding of how to filter out the time and sales. There's not really much to add to the time and sales because what the time and sales is showing you is just the prices at which the orders are being filled on the level 2, right? So thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you enjoy.